Hey, oi, Ted, woohoo! We're at RAF Brize Norton. Ted gets excited here. He loves it. Yeah, I know, Ted, I know. There is a C-17 taking off soon. Ted, I think your phone's going off, mate. Ted? Gorgeous, the 99 Squadron's C-17 there. Look what we've got here, a Dakota. It's Foxtrot Zulu 626 serial. Wow. Oh, what we got here, look at this guy. Not far from RAF Brize Norton is RAF Fairford, and on approach there, at RAF Fairford, is this Boeing 777-200. And it is Omni Air International. And if I've got this right, this perhaps is carrying the personnel for the B-52s that are coming in soon. Oh, guys, departing now is an A400M Atlas. Oh, yes. Just listen to it. Wonder why they still make propelled planes, and it literally is down to their fuel efficiency and their, you know, their economy, and also they sound nice. Here we go, a C-17 taking off, Zulu 177. I thought, Ted, that was impressive. That was something else, wasn't it? Look at that.
Flight Air Golf India, Bright Zone, good morning. Basic service, Bright QNH 1027.
Already this morning, it's been very active. C-17s, A400 Atlas, and now a Herc. Oh yeah, come on, Ted, bring that luck. I mean, it would be an unusual day if you don't see a minimum of, let's say, 5 movements at RAF Brize Norton. But you know, there's always something going on here, and in the end, they are responsible for air-to-air refueling of our Royal Air Force and NATO aircraft. RAF Brize Norton is the largest Royal Air Force station, and it's got approximately 5,800 service personnel with 1,200 contractors and 300 civilian staff. The A400 Atlas entered operational service with the Royal Air Force in 2014. It can take as many as 116 troops, vehicles, helicopters, and it can actually accommodate a Chinook. Oh yeah. Ted, we're at Brize Norton again. We like it here, don't we? It's good, isn't it? Right, what we got now? An A400M Atlas on low approach. Yes, awesome. It's over there. All right, so here we go. Ted, you like this, mate. It's got a wingspan of about 4 Typhoons. Oh yeah, you like that. Comes, mate. Oh, it's going to be good. There are 4 squadrons at RAF Brize Norton that fly the A400 Atlas, and they are 206 Squadron, 30 Squadron, LXX Squadron, which is 70 Squadron, and XXIV Squadron, which is 24 Squadron. They all play similar roles, except that 206 is a test and evaluate squadron. 30 Squadron provide the RAF's tactical airlift capability. 70 Squadron provide strategic air transport worldwide. And then we have 24 Squadron, OCU, the Operational Conversion Units. They are responsible for the training of the RAF Strategic Air Mobility Fleet. So you'll notice some Royal Air Force squadrons present their squadron number in Roman numerals, and this is just pure tradition to present their squadron number. Easy, son, easy. Bit wobbly there, mate. Easy, son. Get that control. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, you got it. Oh, tippy toe, bouncy, bouncy. You got it.
Oh, delicious. Now we just need a nice sharp turn. Come on. Go on, show us your side. Oh. Literally, just took off and it's coming down. Final gear down, here we go. Clear to land. No, I wouldn't do that here, mate. You're gonna lose that, Barry, and no, just no, Ted. Coming in, Ted. Comet 45. A Herc. Here we go. In and we got Herc coming in, Ted. This is Ted Coningsby and team, and we're at RAF Brize Norton.
seeing now is the Voyager. That's it. Call sign Tartan 19 all year. Serial Zulu Zulu 330. About to go on a refueling sortie. Look at that. So we have 10 Squadron providing state-of-the-art air tanker and transport operations, and it is the first ever A330 Squadron. So the Voyager is the RAF sole air-to-air refueling tanker, and it also operates as a strategic air transport. It's taken part in many sorties and operations, especially Opshader, providing air-to-air refueling for our Royal Air Force's Typhoons. Just listen out for the wishily whooshy sound as she fires up ready for takeoff. It is something else. And yeah, may need to put seatbelts on your ears, guys, because you're about to get the sounds of their life. Here they go. RAF Brize Norton also hosts many lodger and reserve units, so you'll get a lot of practice diversions and training from pipers such as this one. Thank you.
So we have Zulu Mike 409, call sign Comet 45 on a low approach. Wow.
In time.
good day, haven't we, mate? It's been brilliant, isn't it? I know. So we're just about to see the last one come home. Well, for today anyway, until later. So we're waiting for the Voyager Tartan 19. Ted, where are you, mate? Calm down, Ted. Calm down. Yeah, Ted loves the RAF. I want to say thank you to all the crew, all the personnel that defend our skies, working constantly every day.